Hello everyone, welcome to this online seminar conducted by ITLS Academy Lucknow. I am Dr. Naveen, going to deliver lecture on the topic Unintentional Food Contaminants and Food Safety Hazards. Everybody nowadays is concerned about the food they are eating and demand for nutritious and healthy food. But food available in market is not suitable for consumption at a large extent, because it is either adulterated or contaminated. It is not necessary that people all the time make food unsafe or adulterated. Sometimes food becomes unsafe unintentionally, and sometimes even people are unaware of their general activities, which may also make the food unsafe. So in this lecture, we will have an overview of general food contaminant. So first, understand the meaning of unsafe food. This definition is taken from FSSAI regulation, that is Food Safety Standard Authority of India. It is very long definition, but it covers all the activities which make food unsafe. In general, unsafe food means which is not suitable for consumption, and it may become unsafe or unsuitable by a number of means. For example, by nature of food itself, that during storage or processing it gets spoiled, or some harmful changes occur in the food, or some harmful matter come in food during packaging, processing or cooking, or it may be made unsafe by people intentionally. The next term is adulterant. Adulterant means any substance which is employed to make the food unsafe, or to make the food substandard or misbranded, or the food which contains the extraneous matter. Contaminant means any substance, whether added to the food during processing or at any step, or which is naturally present in the food and make the food unsafe for consumption, is known as contaminant. Hazard means any agent which makes the food harmful for the consumer is known as hazard. There are three types of hazard: biological, means some microbes, chemical, some chemical substances like urea, or physical agents, for example wood or metal or glass. These substances, they make the food harmful for the consumer, and these substances, they are known as hazard. So let's see this figure to better understand this unsafe food and how the food becomes unsafe. So food may become unsafe by adulteration or by contamination. Adulteration is intentional, contamination is unintentional. Adulteration has motive of getting more profit. Contamination has no such motive. It sometimes happen by itself. Adulteration may be done by adding some physical substances in the food, or by some chemical changes, or by adding some chemical substances in the food. Physical substances, for example, by addition of brick powder in the chili powder, and chemical means by addition of urea in the milk. And adulteration may also be done by removing the superior ingredient of food and replacing it with some inferior ingredient. For example, replacing the fat from the milk with the vegetable oil. That is also a kind of adulteration. Contamination may happen by three means. by entry of physical substances, that is physical hazards, or by chemical means entry of the chemical substances into the food, or biological means by growth of microbes which are harmful for the consumer. So first is physical hazard in the food. Physical hazard means the substances, for example glass, metal, plastic, stone, wood, bones, which make the food harmful for the consumer. Some of these are added from external sources, and some are, for example this bone, they are naturally present in the food. Physical hazard may pose health risk to the consumer because they are hard and sharp object which may cut the mouth or throat, which may damage the intestine, which may damage the teeth or gums. And also these physical hazard, if present in food, may result to the food recall. So that food recall will affect the brand name of the company, and also that is economic burden over the company. These are the factors which determine the potential risk. Size of the extraneous matter means whether it is a big piece of metal or small piece of matter. Type of consumer means the product in which the physical hazard is present is to be consumed by infant or the old age people or the adult. So accordingly, risk level changes. Type of products, whether that product is infant formula. So if it is infant formula and to be consumed by the infant, then the risk is very high. Then the physical characteristics of the physical hazard means the sharpness or the hardness of the object increase the risk level. So the company or the manufacturer of the food substances must prevent the entry of the physical hazard in the food system, and for that they may apply a number of steps. For example, inspect raw materials and food ingredients before starting the food manufacturing. Raw material which is coming from different sources, that may be coming from the agricultural field or maybe from some other industry, so that must be properly examined for the presence of any physical hazard that may be containing wood substances or that may be containing bone. So they must be examined and removed from the raw material. Food must be handled as per the good manufacturing practices. So good manufacturing conditions must be maintained in the processing area. Elimination of the potential source is also required. For example, the processor must not use breakable glass in the processing area, because that breakable glass is the potential source for physical hazard. Install an effective detection and elimination system for physical hazard. Processor may use these detector, magnetic detector, metal detector, X-ray detector or food radar system, which may detect the presence of foreign substances in the food, and that's why they can be employed to detect and eliminate the foreign substances from the food system. Establish an effective maintenance program for equipment, because equipment, they can also serve as the source of physical hazard, because equipment containing some bullets, those bullets or nuts may come into the food system, so they must be properly maintained to eliminate the risk of physical hazard. Next is chemical contaminant. Chemical contaminant means different substances which may pose some health risk to the consumer if present in the food system. Example of chemical contaminant like mycotoxins, natural toxins, marine toxins, environmental contaminants, food additives, processing induced chemicals, pesticides, veterinary drug residues. Some of these are naturally present in the food system, like natural toxins, and some are added during the processing steps. For example, food additives, they are used as an ingredient during the manufacture of food substances. There are a number of food additives which perform a number of functions in the food products. For example, artificial color, artificial sweeteners, artificial flavor, natural flavor, humectant, and a number of functions are performed by these food additives. Any substance before becoming food additives must have gray status. Only then that substance becomes food additive and permitted to be used in the food system. And food additives, they must be used in permitted level. If they are used in excess amount, then they become health safety hazards. For example, recently the issue of Maggi happened because of the presence of monosodium glutamate. Environmental contaminant. Example of environmental contaminants are heavy metals. Same case which happened with the Maggi, that Maggi was containing high level of lead. That was the environmental contaminant. Marine toxins, natural toxins, and mycotoxins. These toxins may result in the food intoxication to the consumer. We will discuss these later on. Processing induced chemicals. Some chemicals, they are generated during the processing steps. For example, acrylamide, which is generated during the processing and which pose health hazard to the consumer. Pesticides, which are used in agriculture, in the industrial premises to kill the pest, and these pesticides, they are coming into the food chain and causing a lot of problems. Veterinary drugs residues. Veterinary drugs are used in the livestock to cure the disease of animals. They are used in the poultry. These veterinary drugs, they are also coming into the food and they results in different health issues. Mycotoxins, they are produced by fungi and can be toxic to the humans and animals. Example of mycotoxins are aflatoxins, ochratoxins, fumonisin, deoxynivalenol, and betulin. They are found in different food commodities. Naturally occurring toxins. These naturally occurring toxins, they are present in the plant naturally and they are produced by the plants as a defense mechanism to protect themselves from the bacteria, fungi, insects, and predators. Example of naturally occurring toxins are lectins, cyanogenic glycosides, glycoalkaloids, 4-methoxypyridoxine, muscarine, Other examples are trypsin inhibitor, solanine. Those naturally occurring toxins may result in nutrient deficiency, they may result in some allergic reactions, and they may also cause food poisoning. These are the marine toxins which are found in different seafoods. Example are histamine produced by some bacteria which grow on these fish, and when these fishes they are consumed by the consumer, they suffer from fish poisoning. Example is scrumpro, toxic fish. Then Sciuratera poison, which is caused by the sciotoxins produced by tiny sea plants called dinoflagellates. These dinoflagellates, they produce a number of toxic compound and which results in different poisoning. Next is heavy metals. Heavy metals includes heterogeneous group of the compounds, and heavy metals refers to the metals which have specific weights more than 5 gram per cubic centimeter. They are not easily degraded in the system, and when they come in the food, they persist longer time and they pose a number of health issues to the consumer. Some of the heavy metals, they are essential. For example, copper, zinc, cobalt, they are required in our body for different functions. Some non-essential heavy metals are also there, like barium, aluminium, lithium. Some are less toxic. Tin and aluminium, they pose lesser health issues, but some are very highly toxic. Example are mercury, lead, and cadmium. These heavy metals, when ingested by the humans, they result in many diseases. They affect the nervous system, they affect the respiratory system, they affect our intestine, digestive system, liver, kidney, and hence they result in a number of diseases. That's why their consumption must be reduced, which are coming into the food system through different pathway. They are excreted by industries as effluents, and they are used in different equipments, and from all these sources they are coming into the soil, they are coming into the water, and from soil and water they are taken up by the plants. Then those plants are eaten by the humans and animals also. Animals, then they are consumed by humans, and ultimately they are coming into the human and causing a number of problems. Selenium in lesser amount is required by our body, but in excess amount that can result in neurological defects. Then pesticide is pesticide contamination of food product is very common nowadays, and a number of pesticides which are used in agricultural practices and industrial premises, they are coming into the food through the different pathway, and they are causing a number of diseases. Number of cancer cases, they are increasing, and reason is presence of pesticide and heavy metals in the food system. These kind of news are very common nowadays. Pesticides which are used in agriculture, soil, they are taken up by the insect, they are taken up by the plants, animals coming into the water, from the water they are coming, in the fish body, and when these dairy products, meat products or food products, they are consumed by the humans, ultimately they come into the body and they bioaccumulate in the human body. They are persistent in nature, means they are not destroyed. They keep accumulating in the higher order, and ultimately humans are suffering a lot from the consumption of these pesticides. These pesticides, they cause a number of diseases. They affect our eyes, they cause the Parkinson disease, they cause headache, loss of consciousness, they cause cancer, because these pesticides, they are carcinogenic. They result in early puberty, they decrease the fertility, they cause diabetes and obesity, they result in allergic sensitization and a number of other health complications. Then third one is the biological hazards, means the microbiological hazards, viruses, fungi, bacteria, parasites. Some of the microbes, they are useful and they are used in the food products, but some of the microbes, they are undesirable. They grow in the food and they result in the spoilage of the food. The biological hazards or the microbes which causes disease to the humans are known as pathogens. Some of these microbes, they themselves causes infection in the humans when they are ingested along with the food, and some of them, they produces toxins. When those toxins, they are consumed by the humans, then they results in food intoxication. So the entry or growth of microbes must be prevented by maintaining the hygienic conditions and by properly handling the food products. Means the food products must be stored properly at appropriate temperature. They must be cooked properly. They must be treated with some processing steps to kill the microbes and to make the food safe. So these are the unintentional food contaminants which we have discussed today. So let's end this seminar here. Thank you.